Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn. In this tutorial, we're going to look at drawing substitutions, which is used for lip sync, but can also be used for eye blinks. This tutorial follows on from my previous tutorial on invert cutting. If you haven't watched this, I'll place a link in the video description below. The assets you'll need is a drawing of an eye. You'll need to separate out the line art and color art into separate art layers. Go to the drawing panel and check that the line art is indeed just the line art and the color art has got the fill. First of all, let's select the drawing node and we can go to our timeline and hit O to take us to the right drawing layer. Over here in the library panel, we can see we've got one drawing substitution and it's named as the current frame. To make sure that happens, you can set it up in your preferences. I can select exposure sheet and check use current frame as drawing name. Let's go ahead and put in another drawing. To do that, it's better to be in the drawing panel. This is frame number one, and I want to move to the next frame. You can use the shortcut on your keypad. The full stop is to move forward, or the comma to move back. Alternatively, shortcuts F and G. On frame two, I'll add an empty exposure to create an empty drawing. I'll put onion skin on so I can see my previous drawing. Select the pencil tool and the right color, set your size, and then draw in the next frame for your eye. Adjust it using the contour editor. Move to the next frame, add another empty keyframe, and then repeat the process. On this one, we'll just do a closed eye. Remember to try to keep as few points as possible. So let's go to the camera view and have a look at what that looks like. I can go through my frames and take onion skin off so you can see the blink clearly. Okay, so now we've made the drawing substitutions, we can see over here in the library all the drawings that we've made. We can also see the drawings in the drawing substitution panel over here. The original drawing is currently on frame one, and if we move through them using our shortcuts, we can see the next position of the blink on drawing substitution two. And then drawing substitution 3 is almost closed, and drawing substitution 4 is fully closed. We can see the drawing substitutions in the library, which is great, but we're not seeing the pupil in the new drawings. So to do that, let's separate out the line art and the color art. Before we do that, for speed, we can introduce a new tool, Apply to All Frames. Go to the frames that need to have line art and color art separated, select the function here, create color art from line art, select the color art layer, and you can see the stroke in the drawing panel. Shortcut K to show stroke. And then we want to choose the paint tool. Choose your color. I have a color I pre-made for the eyeball, which is white, and we can drop that in. And now, if we go back to the camera, we can see all frames have had the same application, which is fantastic. And because you've already rigged it, let's go ahead and have a reminder of our node view. It works in the same way for each one of the replacement drawings. When I select the pupil, go to my next frame, I can move it and it's been invert cut. One thing to remember when you're rigging is to take animate off to avoid any unwanted keyframes. To finish the setup, we can delete the frames that we made. Don't worry, they remain in the library once they've been saved. But to do that, don't hit the delete key, go to remove key exposure to remove frames. If you hit delete, you'll leave a gap in your key exposures. What we can see is we've got the first replacement drawing here. Let's go to the library again so we can see that clearly. Select the eye. So this is the first drawing substitution. Using keyboard functions, the square brackets next to the P, when you hit the first or second square bracket, you can move either backward or forward. It moves through all your drawing substitutions in chronological order. So here is a simple way to animate a blink and not have to redraw the blink every time. It also means that you stay on model and consistent. For more tips on rigging the eye, visit my Rigging a Character Head playlist. See you next time.